When do we start? We pray. We don't pray. We pray, but we just pray now. The heavenly one, there is the board. Okay. So, this is environmental science class, week 2. We're just going to pray. Okay, I'll pray. Father God, thank you so much for this day and for those awesome students. Just thank you for the online students too. Okay, we take it. Okay, we thank you for them too. And I pray that everybody would successfully learn what they need to learn from this class. And I pray, God, that the electronics would work. Give me wisdom to kind of, just give me wisdom. If the microphone is not working, just send the Holy Spirit, let me know. And just thank you, God, for the opportunity to learn all about, you know, what we're going to learn, and like to have our own opinion, you know, to be able to also look at things through your word, the way you said things are, and not to be stuck to have to look through the perspective which everybody else is looking at. So thank you for the freedom. His name? So let's clarify for the assignments. The labs are due on Monday, and if you can, some labs you cannot turn, you cannot type it because it just, I gave you what's the name? I gave you like handout with a bunch of questions copied, so it's hard to type it. You can turn it on paper as well. Or if you do the lab in class, you can just turn it during class, it's fine. If you can, you know, turn the labs on the, so there are two classes. One class is lab, and the other is just environmental science, right? So the labs will need to be turned into the lab class, right here, assignment. Oh, okay, now, that's what I'm explaining. Okay, so see somebody turning there the tragedy of the commas. Let's see who this was. Grace, she turned her, you see, she turned in her assignment already, she typed it, so I can go and look at it later. So what you need to do, you need to go on Populi, find the assignment. It says, no, okay, let's go back. Right here. So one of the assignments is the classwork, and the other one is, one of the assignments is the classwork, and the other one is write up. All right? Okay. It says classwork, write up. So I need to turn in the write up, you know, in there. If you do it in the other one, it's okay. We'll figure it out, but this is the idea. So those are turned on Populi. I haven't set the dates, I guess. I need to work on this. This is not completely done. This is the last one I haven't, but this assignment is there. Right. Okay. We got this part. So then for the rest of the assignments, they need to be actually turned into the regular class, Populi. We're going to the regular Populi right here. Happy birthday. Who had happy birthday? Let's see, who had happy birthday? Who? Oh, Celia, okay. Well, she's not taking this class, okay. So here is environmental science. Let's go to the assignment. Okay. Wow, who, I bet this is Grace. Let's see, is it Grace? Yay, it's Grace, okay. So, okay, this assignment is due on Wednesday, but I sent a message saying if you do it today, it would be great, because technically I wanted to do it today, but I didn't tell you about it, so I felt like I should give you the Wednesday. Now I'm telling you about it. Okay. So what is due on Wednesday? So here we go. Okay, so Wednesday, we're starting right here, September 2nd. Culture capacity, so it's a handout I gave you. It's in your binder. So the online students, I have two more binders. I think Robbie and Manny. The binders are here with all the labs and assignments. So you need to come and pick up your binders at some point. They're white binders, and they're next to the sink. In two white binders. So what you need to do for Wednesday, you need to read this. Right? And there are questions which came with it. You need to answer the questions. So here I gave them to you, right? Yes. But also I gave you the file with the questions. So here, when you click here. Here is the article and the questions. So people who are online, they can actually open the article and read it online or print it. And the questions are available as a Word document, so you can fill it in if you want right there. Okay. So this is this article. We might talk about it today, though, since Grace read it, so we can. So the next thing due on Wednesday, it's a fun lab thing. It's also in your notebook, in your binder. It is somewhere in your binder. And it's, oh yeah, here it is. This is the lab. It's right before, yeah, it's called Ecological Footprint Calculator, right here. It's a fun thing. You need to go, and the instructions are in the file right there. You can find them inside the... Yeah, Wednesday too.
So that one requires to be filled out. That's online too. But then it also asks
did you
to
do
compare
it?
With other people.
Yes.
Do we do that in
so,
the
yeah, what it did, yeah, I said, you know, if you look at the paper, it says go to the... enter your number because it's going to, this is your ecological footprint. What's ecological footprint? Anybody remember? Anybody read the lesson one? Okay, nobody can say, okay, well, it's, okay, so, I know. Ecological footprint is the impact your lifestyle is making on the earth, right? Your consumption of resources. So you have, there is a website, Elizabeth did it. So what, tell us Elizabeth about how did it go, the assignment.
So when you log in, you can go into like a quiz thing where it asks about how you live, how you travel in your day-to-day, how you eat, and the type of building or new house. And based on all the details that you give, and depending on how many details you give, it calculates how big everybody lives the same way that you live every day, how many worlds would you need to be able to have sufficient energy for that, of a world's lifestyle? And so, yeah, that's what we compare.
Yeah, so we want to compare, you know, like, let's say how many Earths Elizabeth needs versus Grace, you know, because it's really fun. It's like a quiz, you know, there are pictures, you know, what you eat. Depending on what you eat, you consume less or more resources. I never done a discussion post, but I said, okay, let's, once you're done, go to the discussions. And it says, where is it? I put it on. Did I put it in the labs? It should not be in the labs, but let's check if I did it. Because I remember I made one, the first discussion post I made. Maybe it disappeared. Maybe it was due to then disappeared. Huh? Okay. So better. Do they disappear after you? Ah, here it is. Okay. I made mistake. Okay, my mistake. But let's do it. I guess it's in labs. Okay, everybody pay attention. The discussion is in the labs. So what you need to do, you need to go there and I don't know what you do with the discussion. You click on it again and say something. You need to say the result. It says right here. Compare your number with the rest of the class. Who has the highest? So you need to post on the discussion board. Right? When you get there, post your number and then you need to look like, you need to look what the other people say. Right? So we can see who has the highest. I guess I should have done a put a deadline. Is there a deadline for the discussions? Okay. Okay, we're working on. Right, got it? So this is due on Tuesday. So two things on Tuesday, and there is a movie too. Hey. Wednesday. Okay. So going back. Okay, four. Okay, going back to the environmental science. So the movies, here you go, assignments. And again, I was not organized with the movies because I was not sure how to do it exactly, but you get there. Okay, so the next thing due on September 2nd are the movies. So the movies are Soylent Green or Idiocracy, the movie. Right? Yes, and to fill the, here is the video response sheet. still get it? Did you see it? It's right. It's right there as well, but it looks like that. I've never done this. I stole it from internet. I didn't steal it. It was free. Somebody was offering for free, a teacher. But you know, just somebody made it. It wasn't me. It sounded like a good idea to have a space like to jot down notes, but then you need to do at the end, you know, do the reviews. But I want to see your notes too. I want you to turn them in. So I don't know if you can type it here without messing up the format, or you can just type it with the, just type it as a plain text. Yes, it would be nice because the online students cannot turn it in. Oh yeah, so because like for example, which movie did you watch?
I watched Soil and Green, and I watched.
Oh, she got more. So you can say, okay, just you know how sometimes I give questionnaires and I'm like give you questions so to see if you watch the movie. So you can ask which year was this, or like what was the name of this person, or why, or yeah, something from the movie, or why do you think this happened?
So it's like you know the answer.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, you need to write the answer. Just example question. What would you ask somebody? You know, like.
It
just,
I would have to look that.
No, no. This is the way. The idea is so I can get enough answers. And next year I'll say, you know what, let's just cheat. You know, for those, I'll make a real questionnaire. No. Sounds like a great idea. Although I have questionnaires for those, but it's okay. Let's try this way. Just three questions. Yeah, you don't understand. It's like, what is something you want to ask? It's totally free. It is, you know, like to watch it and for me to have some proof that you watch it, especially that I can ask you questions, but the people who are online, I don't know if they watch it or not. Right? And then on the back, you know, the reviews, this is for this movie. I might change it later, but, you know, like, the movies you're watching are controversial, like the abortion one, particularly. So you can write, find four reviews in the media, whatever, from different sources, see what they say. Some people say, oh, it's biased, it's horrible. Some people say, oh, it's great, you know. Find four different reviews and see, you know, do it brief, but still kind of explain what the review says and do you agree or... This is due on Wednesday. Three things. Then let's go back here for next Monday. Okay, next Monday, what is due? C6th. The reading guide questions are due now on Monday. And you know the reading guide? So you have to read by then the chapter 1 and 6. All right. What is it? Yeah, 5 is just one little part of 5. So, what is it? 1 and 5, you're right. So this is short. So here is the reading guide. Again, it's a binder as well. But it's also available online. It's right in the, where the syllabus is. The syllabus right here. It's right there under files.
So this whole little packet is
reading. No, the whole thing. Just chapter 1. Chapter 1 and chapter 5, not the whole, just the first two. Hold on, Elizabeth. Yeah, you need to type the question. You can type them on the just on any Word document. Yeah. Just so, you need to, this is the reading guide. Tells you everything we're going to read from the book in this semester, right? Everything is here. And the questions I want you to answer is, you know, like question 1. There is only one question for you to answer from chapter 1. Right? It's right there on the bottom. It says questions. So you need to type it. And then from chapter 5. Chapter 5 again is short. We are going to go over it a tiny bit today. There are 2 questions. Right. So you need to type those questions and turn them in electronically. So everything needs to be electronic, turn it electronically, other than the lab. Sometimes for the labs, you can turn them electronically. If you're here, you can turn them on paper. Yes, the labs. Because if you do them here, you know why type them. So, I don't know if this is on, but I hope it's on. Okay. Yeah, I recorded on Thursday. The whole 3 hours were silent. So, Gary, do you have questions on the homework? So far. Yeah, it's... I didn't explain it well the first time. So let's go back assignments. Here we go. Hannah, do you know how to turn in files on Populi? Did you get, do you know how to
submit homework? I thought it, I was looking for like lab one.
Ah, okay.
So good.
So footprint, so movies, then reading guide. And then for the 9th, the next Wednesday, you have to watch by then the other, two of the other three movies, right? Choose two, it says two of the movies. And right, for each one you need to turn in the reading, the video response. This brings me to the calendar. So the field trip actually is going to be a real field trip because I called this place called Hope Medical. And they said, sure, you can come in. They have a room upstairs where it's a big room. So we are actually going to go inside and then talk to us. You know, we see the place. And then we meet the lady. So on the 9th, the lab. So next Wednesday, not this Wednesday, the week, next week, Wednesday. The whole class would be a field trip. Right? So Wednesday. So let me write it down here. Let's take a picture of this homework. Before we erase the board. Oops. One picture of the homework. Okay. Then we're going to erase the board. And write what's going to happen on September 9th. If you are from Bulgaria, September 9th is the... It used to be celebrated before. It used to be the kind of national holiday before. It was when, during the Second World War, like the Russian, because the Russian army was kind of fighting the Germans in approaching to Europe. So when they came to Bulgaria, it was September 9th. And this is when the socialism started. Because when the Russians came, they kind of won. So now we are under their kind of influence. Now we don't celebrate anymore. We cry on this day. But, okay. This is what it was. So September 9th. Want another color? Okay. September 9th, we're going on a field trip. 9. It's Wednesday. Not this Wednesday, next week. So, attention. So, next week. So next week, we're going to be at 11:30. So, just if you have a class here, you can leave probably 10 minutes earlier. Do you have a class before that? So, we're going to meet at this place called Hope Medical. We're meeting at the parking lot, so it is next to the mall. Let's find the address. Oopsie. Here we go. Man, we're wasting. Oh, it's okay. It's not wasted time. It's good. Hope. Here we go. Right here. So, this place is, what is the address? Let's see what kind of pictures. The address is... 7500 Arrowhead. Here's the address. You can write the address if you need to. We're meeting at the parking lot. I'm showing the picture. It's you need to. I don't think you need to make a left. How can make left when you exit? You kind of need to. It's like where some furniture store is. You can take the back street or just make some kind of turn there where the mall is. Here is the address. And this looks like that. Yeah, nobody knows. It's right, actually right across the street. This is, it looks like that. Do we have more pictures? Let's see if there are more. No, you'd make it. So this is how it looks, the building. You cannot see it, but it's kind of like there's some kind of trailer park there too, and this Planned Parenthood right there. You can see it from their window. I don't want to tell anything. I'll leave the guy tell the story. So that's why I'm like saving it for that. Okay, got it. So we'll be there from 11:30. We're done probably whatever 1:30 because after that we'll walk with the lady down. This prayer warrior lady. I'll tell about it. Okay. Margie Hurt is it right there. She's amazing, but I'll tell you about her later. Okay, let's get to business now. Got it? Hannah, you got it? Next Wednesday? Not this Wednesday, we're going on a field trip.
Oh, I just wrote it down.
Good, good. Okay. Yeah. You need to, yes. You can turn it by hand.
Okay.
But you can type it in if you're feeling inspired.
Well, I have the note that just turned in.
Yeah.
But like the actual part. Like
So yeah, turn it in paper.
Okay.
Yeah. Turn it in paper.
So you want that part.
I want this part too, yeah.
Okay. Because I did like the questions. I typed them up, but the actual like filling out.
Yeah. So yeah, the people, I mean, nobody can do it at home, they cannot do it at home, so never mind. So whoever is taking it online, you guys know that you cannot take this class without the lab. So you need to figure out what you're doing. But you won't be passing this class without the lab.
That's not good.
Not good. Okay. So. Okay. Okay. So we got it. So then let's stop with all this. Administration stuff and start with our excitement. Yes. Semester. I wish it was here because there's so much stuff and I'm cramming it all in because it's so cool, but why? Things are okay. So we're starting Chapter 6, and we're going to go to 5. We just go back. It's about human population. So if you have your book, Chapter 6 is about human population. So I selected, because it's not semester class, because it's not a year class, you cannot cover all the topics because this is a year, book. So I selected the topics which make more sense to me. And the topics I have some expertise in, because I don't know biology, disclaimer, probably I did it the first class. So I try to avoid the topics which deal with all kinds of animals. And I mean, I know stuff about it, but still, we're not going to get into details about that. But we're starting with the human population, because this is something we hear all the time. As Christians, we need to definitely have a stand on this, know what we're thinking about human population. Okay, so what do you think? I asked you before, but let's start again. What is the biggest environmental problem according to you right now? What do you think it is? If somebody meets you, it's a don't worry, your opinion, if you have one, it might change later, just whatever you think. There is no wrong opinion, really. So Elizabeth, what do you think if somebody tells you you need to solve one problem, pick the most important environmental problem to solve, what would it be?
Environmental.
Yeah, something with the saving the environment. What do you think?
I don't really think about that.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Water pollution? What is it? Food? What about food? Oh, okay. Grace, what is your, what do you think?
I kind of lean more towards like the garbage problem.
Okay, the pollution. And Elizabeth, actually, it's very good that you don't have opinion, because now we're going to learn so much about all the problems that now you have opinion. My goal is,
I'm very, everything I think about is very God-centered, so I guess we lead with grace about pollution, because that's something that we can control. Other than that, reproduction, we have full control of it. That's why
the garbage. Okay, the pollution. Okay, good. And Isaac was mentioning about population. If you actually ask many people outside, they'll tell you that the overpopulation is the worst problem, because this is what I like. So, okay, so who do you think, like, where do you think all those opinions come? Like, when you watch the news, how do you think they determine what to talk about? What do you think? Where, like, because you can talk about so many things, how do they get the idea what to talk about concerning the environment, let's say the environment?
Politics.
Politics, okay. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I think it's, I don't know. I think it's mainly actually I kind of know, but it's more like conspiracy theories. But it's not. You know, this is, we know how it is. Money, okay. Money is what governs everything, really. This is what it is. Money and power in, you know, in the media, the politics. So, you know, the politicians, they, you know, all those reporters, they have clues from somewhere. You know, I've seen movies, we all seen movies when the reporter wants to be independent, really say the truth and, you know, what happened to them. You know, usually there is this like party policy saying, okay, this is what we're going to be now addressing. It's all where the money are. But if you ask many people, they think that overpopulation is the problem because they're afraid that, you know, there are so many people that we cannot support, the earth cannot support it. And so it's craziness, honestly. So maybe this is a good homework we can do. Ask, do you have any friends who are like not friends? I mean, friends. Let's find friends who are not like Christians. Do you have any like those?
We could probably do a poll.
Okay,
she has
some. Oh, poll on Facebook. Okay, great idea. Poll your friends on Facebook. Ask them. Okay, just ask them, what do they think, what do you think is the biggest environmental problem? Just ask them, don't tell them any. Just ask them, what do they think is the biggest environmental problem? It would be interesting. Grace, do you have Facebook? I don't have Facebook, so. Yeah, I mean, you're in the same category, but they can.
Huh? Well, Instagram.
The Instagram. Do you have Instagram?
Put on the story and then you go where you, like, look for hashtags and stuff, and put poll.
But just poll your friend, you know. Poll whoever you want, really. Ask them, for ask them two things. Okay, let's see two things. Ask them, what is the most, like, the biggest environmental problem to solve? And then ask them, do you think there is overpopulation? Let's see. Let them answer the first one and then ask them the second. Let's see what they're saying. Okay. So for overpopulation, yeah, I don't know, my thought is going different, but to figure out how many people, okay, we need to know how many people are right now on the earth. What is the world population, do you know? Billions, okay. Let's just go find out right here. I guess my PowerPoint, go bye-bye. Let's go here, right here. 7 billion in 2010, okay, so let's see. I have right here, world population.
And then we're like at the limit. I think he said that we needed to be like.
Did you read it?
Yeah.
But you didn't turn it in. Oh, good. You read it. Okay. Where is the total population? 54.
Don't go telling people.
Where? Oh, right here. Oh, 7 billion. Okay, okay. 7 billion. Almost 8.
Oh, no.
You see right there?
The global human carrying capacity is 50 billion.
Wow. So this is the thing. Okay. Right now, we're 7 billion here, almost 8. I know. And the thing is, you know, I don't think, are they counting in Africa? I don't think this is connected to every country. But if you can, so this is just, I don't know, this clock, I'm just, but the number is kind of, okay, the general number. That's what I mean. But, you know, like if you're born in Catholic, they go enter on the computer. Today, they have a data, you know, everybody is supposed to enter data. So, baby's born.
So that's not even,
yeah.
Not even
Yeah, no. Maybe there, I don't know this calculator. Maybe it's over, like, it's over exaggerated. But this is the population number. What is it? No, it's not. We're not 8 billion. We'll hear about it. Okay, let's try another one. Okay, get your phone. Find the current world population. Get another website. Yeah. Well, wait, people die from all kinds of causes. Okay, so get your phone, Isaac, and just Google current world population. Try different website than this one. Get something. Or let's see what it gives. It's actually, I like this because it shows you in real life. This is what is happening. Someone is born. Every second somebody is born. Right there, like somebody dies. It's not like we're not the center. There are so many countries, so many people, and they have computers. Isaac, what you got? It is important. Okay, it's almost okay. So this is what is now. Let's see what is the maximum here. We have it in the PowerPoint. Okay, we can just get, here's an article. Let's see, where is the article? It's right here, I will find it. There are many articles, you know, I just pick one. Oh, here is an article, which people calculated different calculations of how many people can the Earth support. So now we need to define, you know, what is the carrying capacity. So who read, you read, Grace and Elizabeth read those, right? So what's carrying capacity? It's just somewhere there. Did you get it? Okay, I'll get the PowerPoint. Okay. So we need to figure out, let's see if there are 7.8 billion people, how many people can we support? And actually I have it right here from those. Let's see, right here, we need to see what is a carrying capacity first. So this is the definition. So there is cultural and just carrying capacity. There are two types of carrying capacity, but this is the cultural right there. Right. Here is one definition. So cultural carrying capacity is the maximum number of people who would live in a reasonable, oh, you're right, it's reasonable freedom, indefinitely, without decreasing the ability of future generations. So you're living, but you're not destroying the earth, like when you did the fish lab, you know, some of you, year two, there was nothing to eat, right? So how did the fish lab, you know, the lab with the candy go? What happened in the first round for the girls team? You know, the lab we did, so what happened? Did you think you died after the first year? Because of Hannah, she took all the fish. Was it? Okay. So Isaac, how was your team? Your team was kind of doing pretty good. How did you die at all for the first round, the second, third?
No. What we did is that we all agreed to take.
But you're not supposed to talk the first round.
Oh,
you're not
supposed.
No, you're supposed to just like.
Yeah.
You're supposed to the first round. You're supposed to get as many as you can, which represents how people think, you know, if something is free, they'll take as much as they can. Because they don't know you. So what difference does it make, you know? All right, yeah. So culture, so in this, so let's see what the estimations, what?
Right, cultural carrying capacity is different.
Yeah, carrying capacity. So depending how you define carrying capacity, so here is this picture I was trying to get from the, let's make it bigger somehow. This is very bad graph. When you study statistics, it's like, who came up with this? You know, every head is like different.